guys, welcome to Educating Shani. I'm Shani and I have an eating disorder.
Hi, Shani.
Hi. So since Danny ditched out on me on Friday, I had to do Fun Friday all alone.
Poor
so
thing.
Horrible.
Had to work all day. You're so, feel terrible for you.
Today we're going to do another Q&A video for you guys. This is an eating disorder / Danny Shani question and answer video. And then also I have a couple other announcements.
One is I have something stuck in my teeth.
I got it.
Oh, good job.
So the first announcement is that Danny has a YouTube video that somebody made about him. He has a website on Facebook called Iron Dan Designs because he makes all kinds of armors. Like tell them what you do.
I make props and
like
costumes.
Like he makes Iron Man armor. He makes, he made a Groot costume from Guardians of the Galaxy, and he makes it all out of foam or paper or
plastic,
whatever he can find. He's extremely talented. That's why he works for movie sets. He builds props for movies, and he's an artist, and he does everything. So anyway, he had some friends. What were their names?
Her name is Mandy Rogers,
and her husband,
Spencer.
Mandy and Spencer Rogers came over here and made a video just kind of showcasing what Danny does, and so I'm really proud of it. It just barely got posted. Please go watch it. Please give it a bunch of views. Please give it a thumbs up. Please comment on it because he deserves it. So I will put that video, I'll put the link to it in the description below. So please go check that out. I'm really proud of him and you will be too when you see the video. So, okay.
Dang.
And then the second announcement is that Danny's also planning on starting a YouTube channel to do more of the stuff that you see in the video. And I would love it if you guys encouraged him to do so in the comments of that video or this video. And yeah, okay. And the third announcement is that at the end of every video now, I'm going to be, no, that's not right. And the third announcement,
and your nose out your mouth.
And the third announcement is that,
what? What's the third announcement?
I can't do it today. And the third announcement is that I don't know how to word it. That's my problem.
You keep on getting louder and louder every time say it too. You're like yelling now. And the third announcement.
And the third announcement is that I'm going to be putting, okay, you guys, when I started this channel, I did a lot of really good videos in the beginning and not a lot of people saw them because I didn't get the majority of my subscribers till a few months ago. So every video that I make, go look in the description. There's going to be a throwback video for you to go and watch.
Go watch them all, guys.
Yeah,
go back
go
in the
watch
history.
Them.
There's some
Give them
sweet...
some views and some comments. Those were good videos.
They're,
I gave you a lot of
awesome
good information
videos
about different topics. So go and check those out. Let's get started with our first question. Are you ready?
Ready. Okay. Jade Shay asks, why do you do the Hi Shani thing? No offense.
Okay, I get this question a lot, and what this person is talking about is that at the beginning of all my videos, I say, hi guys, welcome to Educating Shani. I'm Shani and I have an eating disorder. Hi Shani, hi. And if Danny's here, I say, hi guys, welcome to, I'm Shani and I have an eating disorder.
Hi Shani.
Hi, the reason I do that, I learned that from EDA meetings, which stands for Eating Disorders Anonymous meetings. It's a lot like AA meetings, which you've heard of, which is Alcoholics Anonymous. And if you know anything about that, at the beginning of all of their meetings, they stand up and they say, hi, I'm so-and-so and I'm an alcoholic. And then the rest of the group says, oh, hi, so-and-so. And then he says, hi. So that's where I get it from. It's just to address. And I thought it would be a good, clever opening for my videos. And so that's where it comes from.
Alice D.
D, Day.
Day, whatever. Hey, Shani.
Hi.
On a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being the absolute horror, how painful were the implantation of the screws, I assume in their teeth? She says, I'll have one too soon, and I'm scared.
Okay, she's talking, I hate showing you guys my teeth. Be warned, I'm a bulimic. I don't like to show you my teeth close up because they're brown and they're rotting and they're disgusting looking and
to show her the teeth.
Okay, so what she's talking about is on my bottom teeth, I have these things that look like little screws. They're called posts, but they look like screws, and it's actually easier to describe it if we use the word screws. So basically, they put those in a couple years ago, and we never ended up being able to go back because we couldn't afford to get the other half of it done. So, but the first half, they put these in down to your, like, as far as it can go, so it's kind of like a bone, essentially, and then they take a fake tooth and kind of screw it on, kind of, and that becomes your tooth. So that's what they're for. So on a scale of 1 to 10, how horrible is it? It's really not that terrible. It's a lot less painful than you might think. It kind of feels like when you have your wisdom teeth taken out, except for not quite as bad. Like, you're knocked out when you do it. They knock you out to do it. So you don't feel it while it's happening at all.
Yeah.
And then when you wake up, you're sore, just like you would be after...
just like any...
Yeah,
any dentistry any, type
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, like a root canal or a wisdom teeth removal. You'll be sore for a couple days, but it's really not as terrible as you think it might be. So I would say it's like a 7. It's really not the end of the world. It sucks, it hurts, but it's really not like unbearable.
You're over it in a couple
days. Yeah. And you just get to eat pudding and ice cream and Jell-O and watch a movie while you recover for a couple days. So it's really not that terrible.
Gabby Archer says, or asks, this may be a stupid question. By the way, this is on the 12 signs of bulimia. And she says, she asks, this may be a stupid question, but if I have some of these symptoms, does it mean I have an eating disorder?
Okay, this is a question that a lot of people ask me, not exactly what she said, but a lot of people ask me, especially on my 12 signs of anorexia and 12 signs of bulimia videos, if they have some of these signs, does that mean they have an eating disorder? So to answer all of your questions, you probably do, but you don't have to go to a psychologist or a psychiatrist to get diagnosed. You can just go to your family doctor. Your family doctor will tell you if you have one or not. You could probably even self-diagnose yourself. Like, it's pretty cut and dry. You either have an eating disorder or you don't. You either do eating disorder behaviors or you don't. It just fill it out. Does it feel like an addiction to you? If you're doing these behaviors, do you feel like it's something you can't stop? Is it something that you can't help doing? And if it is, then go to the doctor. Go to the doctor regardless. Ask the doctor, and most importantly, go and get yourself checked out. Check your heart, check your blood, check your lungs, check everything. All of your organs get so weak when you have an eating disorder that you can die, like, instantly over the stupidest little impact on your body. So it's really dangerous. So go to your
regular,
if you can't afford a psychologist or a psychiatrist, which I understand, I can't right now either, just go to your family doctor and ask them to check you out and diagnose you if they want to and help you. Yeah, get you some help before it gets any worse. So yeah, this is the best question I've ever gotten. Are you ready? Hadil Hussam says, what the is wrong with you? Would you like to answer this?
Let me hit this. Oh, let's see. Severe depression, severe anxiety, bulimia, anorexia, BED,
fibromyalgia, interstitial cystitis, endometriosis, IBS, the thing down there that I'm not going to talk about, and the other thing in the heads where I see people and hear people.
IBS.
And I said IBS.
Oh, I mean, dude.
What's wrong with you?
Yeah, what's wrong with you? Let's hear it. I would like to hear the list of what's wrong with you. Because if you can do half of what's on her list and still function, then I'll give you props, okay? Because I guarantee you do not have half the problems that my Shannon takes into every single day and still does her thing, okay? So, at the door. Hoss. Bleep that out. In fact, kill that whole thing. I don't want to be like that.
This is my favorite question, again. Boomstick Deck Cadet.
Boomstick. Hi, Boomstick.
Your husband is a for putting up with your
whoa.
He should grab you by the arm and take you to the psychiatrist or psychologist. Seek a solution for sake.
Yeah.
Don't just live with it and cope. Listen, sir, First of all, my husband has tried that so many, you got to be mad, I can be mad too. First of all, my husband has tried dragging me literally by the arm to so many doctors you don't even know. Second of all, this man...
Bring it down. Just a little bit.
This man sacrifices everything for me to take care of me every day, to make sure I'm alive, to make sure I stay alive, to make sure I'm eating. He does everything in his power that he can do. You need to realize that this is a disease that will not go away until I choose for it to go away. It has nothing to do with him. And quite frankly, I shouldn't even be like giving your comment any attention, but I'm going to try and stop you and anybody else out there who blames the partner of the eating disorder sufferer to knock it the hell off, because it is not their fault and it's not something they can fix. Only the sufferer can fix it. So back off, buddy. I will find you. I will kick you in the so hard that you will never have your own children.
Calm down.
Next question.
Still Just Faith asks, do you have an Instagram?
I do have Instagram, but I suck at it. This is my goal for the next month, over the next month. I need to get better at doing Instagram and Twitter, because apparently that's where all the youngins are. Apparently you're a dinosaur if you only use Facebook, which is what I do. But my cousin Shannon, the other Shannon.
there's two of them.
Hi Shannon, I love you. Yes, there's two of us. We're so alike. She's going to come over and help me learn how to use Instagram and Twitter. So it might be a little bit till I can get it up and running. But for now, I do have an Instagram, Educating Shanny. There's like 4 videos or pictures on there, not very many.
Here's an interesting question. Danielle or Danelle? So it could be a guy or a girl.
Danelle?
Larick says, you're 30? Damn, you're aging beautifully.
Thank you, I know. First of all, I'm 31. Second of all, if you're wondering why I age beautifully, number one, I don't go out in the sun, which is not healthy. So it's really not that good of a trade-off. But number two, this is a picture of my mother. And she's like 57 years old, right? How old is she? 58.
No,
she's
there.
About to be 58,
somewhere
I think. I don't know. Late 50s, so.
But there you go.
So and thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Hey, back off. She's mine.
Are you jealous?
Let's
I like
move
when
on.
You get jealous.
Thanks.
Zola A.
She says, why do you put this on YouTube? The noise of you throwing up is disturbing.
I put this on YouTube because it's disturbing.
Nothing on YouTube should be disturbing.
I put it on YouTube to get attention, if you want to call it that. Because I'm trying to bring attention and awareness to the severity of eating disorders. And if you don't want to watch it, you don't have to watch it. Like, you don't have to watch, just click away.
No, you know what? Watch
it.
Be disturbed about it.
All I'm trying to do is to show people how serious it is and to wake people up. Either that will wake up somebody who's thinking of trying an eating disorder behavior, which then can turn into an addiction for them, or somebody who's already in it, maybe like a bulimic out there, if they heard that would really kind of like snap it into, like it certainly did something for me when I edited that video. Like, I was shocked when I heard that. Like it all became real that's what I do. And my stomach still drops every single time I watch it, and I cry every time I watch it and every time I hear that part. So it's meant to shock, it's meant to be disturbing, it's meant to show as appropriately as I could, because I actually filmed myself purging, throwing, I filmed my face doing it, but I couldn't, that was disturbing, that would be disturbing, but I felt like that was a little bit too graphic. So yeah, so that's why I do it. There's a reason that that's exactly why I do it, is to bring
awareness,
disturbance
to it.
And awareness, and get people thinking about it. So, yeah. Okay.
I have an analogy. Can I share? Mm-hmm. Think of somebody who smokes a lot, like forever a lot, and you hear them hacking up their black tar. that they just can't, that is just in their lungs now, and you hear that and it just, oh my gosh, it's just
gross. Doesn't that scare you away from wanting to smoke?
Right, exactly.
Doesn't that scare you from wanting to have an addiction to it for so long?
And look at the awareness now that smoking is at.
Yeah.
But I mean, shoot, 10 years ago, it was still the freaking cool thing to do.
Yeah.
If you didn't smoke, you weren't cool. Now it is, if you smoke, you are an idiot. You know, not that you're an idiot, but that's the idea. You're going to die a lot faster if you smoke. It's just proven now.
Yeah.
This is what we're trying to do. We're trying to bring the fact that eating disorders are a proven way to hurt yourself, to
and
die.
And we're trying to prevent people from, stay with me on this, from choosing an eating disorder. Now, you can't choose an eating disorder. That's not what I mean. What I mean is that a lot of eating disorders, my bulimia started this way. My bulimia started with me choosing to purge the very first time. And from then, my addiction grabbed a hold of it, and it was just too late because I already had addiction in me. I had already had another eating disorder prior to that that I wasn't really aware was such a bad thing or an eating disorder. Like you might choose a behavior, but if you have an addictive brain, or if you are like, what's that called? An addiction, you know, chemicalness place up there, then you can get addicted so fast just by doing it once or whatever. So some people do choose right at the beginning. So that's what I mean when I say I'm trying to prevent people from choosing it. You can't choose the addiction. You can't choose it. The addiction is an illness. It's a disease that you cannot help. But you can choose a tool that might get you to that addiction. Just like with smoking, you get lung cancer from it, but you don't really choose to have lung cancer, but you chose to smoke the first time and then it became an addiction and then you got lung cancer. So anyway, I just wanted to clear that up. So yeah, what was the question?
Nazishnadim.
Nazishnadim. Nadim. Sorry. Pretty, whatever it is.
Yeah. Danny, did your feelings change at all when you realized that your wife had an eating disorder? And how did you deal with bad days? How do you deal with bad days? Sure. Good day to ask that.
Today was a bad day.
Today's kind of a bad day. Let's get better. Okay, so first part of this, excuse me. First part of this, no, my feelings did not change for Shannon when I found out she had an eating disorder. I had no idea what it was at the time, so I had no idea how to deal with it at the time. People, your eating disorder is not who you are. Shannon is not her eating disorder, okay? It's something that she suffers from. Just like anybody out there who suffers from any other disease, it's not who they are. It's something that their physical and mental state is suffering from, okay? Now, if you're worried about your partner leaving you because of that, maybe you gotta find someone who can understand you a little bit better, who would accept you just for who you are and not for what you do, all right? If people knew what I do every day, I doubt, you know, I wouldn't be anything to anybody, but it's who I am. It's who Shannon is, not what she does, not what she suffers from. That's not the point here. And how do I deal with bad days? As a supporter, guys, I'm gonna go off on this a little bit, is that okay? As a supporter, you put in what you're gonna get out, okay? I mean, that's just how it is. If you have decided to support someone who is suffering, especially from an eating disorder, number one, you're in for a ride. I'm just gonna warn you, you're in for a ride, okay? You have to be flexible, you have to be available, you have to be patient. Patient beyond all the patience in the world, okay? Luckily, thankfully, I was blessed with a lot of patience, okay? I never understood why until I realized why I was had been patient all my life with other things in my life. And you know, this is why, right here. This is exactly why. No coincidence bullcrap, this is why I have patience, is for Shannon. Because there are going to be bad days, guys. There are going to be terrible days. There's going to be days that sometimes you just don't know what the hell you're going to do. Sometimes there is nothing you can do. Sometimes. The best thing you can do every time is realize just what I said, that these wonderful people are suffering from a disease that makes their mind not think right, makes their body not work right, okay? And they, the interesting, whatever you want to call it, thing is that they actually know this and they're fighting that, okay? When they fight you, they're not really fighting you, they're fighting the disease. The problem is that the disease tricks it so that while they're shooting at the disease,
we take it out on you.
It shoots the supporter. That's what it does. That, and it sucks. It does suck. But I guarantee you, 100 million times, it sucks worse for them. So I guess just man up and deal with it. Man up, be patient, be supportive.
Take care of yourself too, of course.
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah, of course take care of yourself. And I'm not saying, you know, sacrifice everything.
Yeah, don't sacrifice your health and your well-being.
Yeah, you know. I'll be honest, I've probably done that plenty of times, all right? But yeah, totally take care of yourself, but also take care of the person that you're supporting, okay? And that can go for anybody. It doesn't have to be husband and wife. It doesn't have to be a boyfriend, girlfriend. It can be parent and child. It can be child and parent, for crying out loud. It can be friend, friend, okay? Just know that these people out there need your help, all right? And if you can support them, do it. They need it. You're saving their life. All right, let's move on. Thanks, thank you. All right, Sam Phillips asks, wedding pics?
Sure. Okay, this, I love this girl so much. Luisa Dubicus. Okay, so she's adorable. Did you say, okay, so this is on the video where, actually I don't remember which video this is talking about, but I was talking about my children in heaven, and she said, did you say your kids who are waiting for you in heaven? I'm so sorry, what happened to your kids, if you don't mind
crap.
Me asking? I know, I'm so sorry. I should have worded it differently. I didn't mean that I had dead children that are in heaven. I meant my children that are not here yet. Like my children, when I say my children who are waiting for me in heaven, I meant waiting for me to bring them here, not waiting for me to die to join them because they're dead.
I didn't even think about that.
I'm so sorry. I feel so bad that I worded it wrong. We don't have any dead children. They're just in heaven still, They haven't gotten here yet, and so I'm waiting for them to come from heaven, so thank you.
Thank you, though.
You're really sweet.
Yeah, you're a sweetheart.
I'm so sorry. You're really, really sweet. Last question of the day. Esteve Muravska. Don't know how to pronounce that. Could you please stop burping? No. It's okay for like 1-2 videos, but it's just annoying, so just cut it out.
Real quick, first off, we've actually gotten many comments that people love that because it's real. Real people burp there, chick. Okay?
That's when just, I have to burp.
That's just how it is. Sorry
and
if that doesn't
I'm trying
work,
to make
but...
people more comfortable. I know it might make you uncomfortable, but you don't have to watch if it does. I'm a burpy, gassish girl, and I need to burp, and I burp on camera because I'm inappropriate, so.
There you go.
My butthole hurts.
There's your inappropriate for you.
Okay, so thank you for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel and share my videos with people and spread my message and do all the things. Please leave us a comment about anything. Please leave us more questions in the comments below and we will answer them on an upcoming Q&A. Because I'm pretty sure I'm going to start doing a Q&A every week now because I'm getting so many questions come in.
Thank you,
that
guys.
That was not even half of the pile of questions that I have. So yeah. I'm going to start doing Q&As every week. So if you have any other questions, leave it in the comments below and I will let you know when that's going to happen. It'll probably be my Tuesday videos, I'm thinking, but we'll see. So, okay, so that's all. Thank you for watching. You're beautiful.
You're worth it.
And I
am. Oh, are we doing that together? Yeah.
You're beautiful.
You're worth it.
And I am too. Thanks for watching. Bye. Bye. Nope.
Nope. Keep going.
Thank you for watching. Bye.